Hi, and welcome to Stamp with Lisa Brown on my SAVI Sunday video. And today we're going to be talking about our water painters. Stampin' Up! Has come out with some new water painters. And these are paintbrushes that have water in the barrel. And what I like is that they came in this nice carrying case. So you open it up and you have all three painters in here. And each of them come with a different tip. So you have a narrow brush with a fine point, and they have these great caps that snap on and off for storage. You have a larger brush that also comes to a pretty good point. Actually, let me leave the caps off so you can see the difference in the brush sizes. And then what I'm most excited about is this wide brush here, and that's for giving you nice coverage for water backgrounds. So each of them, you unscrew the cap on them, and that's how you put your water in the barrel. Put that back on nice and secure. Okay, so these are great for watercoloring with watercolor pencils, our regular ink pads, and you can really get a nice fine tip on there, or like I said, with the wide brush, get a nice wide coverage on that. And today we're going to be featuring the Arrange A Wreath bundle. You get this great stamp set here with all these fun stamps, and it comes with a whole arrangement. There's 21 different dies in this die set, and it's the Wreath Builder dies. What I like about this stamp set too is that it comes with a whole bunch of different sentiments that you can use for different holidays. You could use it for Valentine's Day, Thanksgiving, Easter, Christmas, or just a best wishes. So it makes this stamp set very versatile, and it can be found on page 127 in the annual catalog, and they have some great examples in the catalog. It is $54 for the bundle. That is a 10% savings when you buy that bundle. And don't forget, in the month of July of 2020, it is our bonus days. For every $50 that you spend, you get a $5 coupon to spend starting on August 4th and throughout the month of August. So purchasing this bundle will automatically get you a coupon. And you can order on my store, which is stampwithlisabrown.stampinup.net. So let's go ahead and get started with our card. Now, using watercolor, you can use two different kinds of paper. You can use Stampin' Up's fluid watercolor paper or our shimmer white. And for today, I'm going to use our shimmer white. And what I've done, now because I have a ton of ink on here, I'm going to reuse it. I took my acrylic block and I actually dabbed it into my ink pad. So this is Granny Apple Green. And I just took my my acrylic block, and I pressed it on the ink pad. And that's where I'm getting all that ink from. I want a color wash covering the majority of my my shimmer white paper. So I'm going to, there's on the barrels of the aqua brushes, there's a word push on that side. And if you rotate it, there's another push right here. So that's where you just want to give it a gentle squeeze, and you can start seeing the water fill the barrel here. You don't want to squeeze too hard. You don't want it come shooting out. So just a nice gentle squeeze to get that water coming. And we have a nice pool of water, and I'm just going to bring it around on my black and pick some up. The more water you use, the lighter your color is going to be. And we're just going to give this a nice wash. I love this brush. Oh my goodness. I do notice that you have to give it a little more water, which is fine. Okay. Because it is a wide brush, and so it's just going to take a little bit more water to do that with. All right, and then I'm going to brush off some water. I have a little towel here, and then on my scrap paper, I'm going to squeeze out and then give this a final squeeze out there. So that's that one. Let me set this block to the side. We're going to use it again in a second. And I'm going to shoot this with my heat tool to give it a dry. Okay, that's good enough for now. Let's see, there's a little bit of residual pooling right there, so I'm just going to stop that up. Okay, so you can now this isn't totally dry, but I'm okay with that just for the purpose of the video. But you can set this aside and dry and do multiple ones to use up some of your ink that you pulled off your block. But we're going to continue on, and I'm going to bring in my Stamparatus, and I'm going to bring in it with the leaf stamp on it, and I'm going to place my watercolored image in here. Set my magnets to hold that down. Let's make sure that my stamp isn't going to hit the magnet. All right, great. I'm going to actually pull this out just a little bit. Okay. All right, now I'm going to take some Cajun Craze and I'm going to ink up my wreath, giving that a couple of presses. Now, I can tell on my wreath that I do not have a complete coverage on there, and I'm going to leave it like that. Right here, I'm missing some ink, and I'm going to leave it like that to show you how you can correct things with your water brushes. Also, I'm going to be watercoloring this out, so I'm okay with there not being total ink coverage. Okay, see how we're missing a lot here? And I will deal with that in one moment. Let me just give this a quick little rub off with my chamois. Get the majority of the ink off. Slide this. Okay. So now I'm going to come in with my medium sized bristle here. And I'm also going to bring in my crumb cake stamp pad, which I've squeezed in the middle. And when you open it up, you have the ink in the lid. So we're going to be pulling some ink from that lid. Again, I'm going to give the sides of the water brush a squeeze. Get the water flowing in here a little bit. And now I'm just going to kind of smudge out. It's going to look crazy. Just bear with me. And I'm going to smudge out this color all the way around. Okay. Get a little more water going. I like to go over my ink pad or like on my scrap paper or work surface, just in case I get a huge pool of water that I don't want. And then go to my project. Depends on what kind of watercoloring you're doing too. So we're going to kind of be covering this up with some dyes, and that's why I just wanted to bring out, you're going to know that these leaves are underneath there, but because we're going to cover them up with some dyes, I didn't need a real sharp image. Just kind of pulling this color out. Now over here you can see I got some leaves missing and whatnot, so let me spread out some of this color over here, and then I'm just going to dry this off just a little bit on my towel, and I'm going to come in here and get some nice color so I can go back and I can add these tips in, so you can really get some pointy edges on these brushes. If you're missing anything or you want to draw your own leaves or words, you can most certainly do that with these. Okay. All right, I'm good with that. Just needed to give it a little more definition. A little more point up here. Okay, like I said, most of this is going to get covered up by some die cuts. So this is, I just wanted to show you with the thicker bristle here, how you can pull some of that coloring out. All right. Okay, so we have a hot mess going on, right? All right, let me put this aside for a second. And in the magic of television video land, I have one prepped for us. And so it's already dry. Okay, so this is one I did earlier, and this is all dry. And here's my Granny Apple Green color wash, and I have mounted it to Granny Apple Green cardstock. And we're going to use Cajun Craze as our card base. So let's go ahead and put that on. Use my bone folder. Okay, and now go in for that nice crease there. All right. Oh yeah, that's going to pull those colors out quite nicely. So I'm going to go ahead and use our Stampin' Seal. And get that stuck on to my card base. Just a nice thin. Now I like to use a little bit thinner borders. So it's a standard card size of 5.5 by 8.5, scored at 4.25. And then my Granny Apple Green is cut to 4 1/8 by 5 7/8. And then the Shimmer White is 4 by 5.25. Okay. So here's our card base. Now I want to go back to the Arrange A Wreath for a minute. And I die cut this berry die. Trying to find where it happened to my dies here. Okay, here we go. Here's our dies. So I took this berry wreath die and I cut that out of pumpkin pie. So we're going to lay that over top. Now see how it's already covering up our watercolor wash. And then this die here is, oh, it's so great. It die cuts and it embosses. So you can see the detail in those leaves of how it put that center embossing on there. And that's going to go right over top. So I'm going to go ahead and get some liquid glue. And oop, came out a little bit. Just put dots of liquid glue around. And I'm going to try to get these berries like going in between here, like so. Okay. And then we're going to do the same thing for the leaves. We're going to adhere the leaves. Now for these dies, I am okay with them not all being stuck down, because some of them will stay kind of popped up and add more dimension to our card. And we'll get that, hold that down for a minute. Okay. Okay, I'm adding some detail. I'm going to go back to one more final step of watercoloring. So in the set, there's this little plaque. I stamped that in Smoky Slate. And then our little give thanks is done in the Cajun Craze. And we're going to put a dimensional on the back of that. I'm going to stick that on. Give thanks right in the middle of our wreath. And there's another die in the stamp set. And it gives you a bow. So I chose that in Crumb Cake. And I think our bow is going to go right here. And I'm going to put it on with a little mini dimensional. I'm going to try to get that little mini dimensional right in the center of that bow. Okay. I'm going to stick that right there. All right, great. Okay, so I wanted to add one more element to the corner of my card. So I'm going to set this aside for a moment. And I'm going to bring in a scrap piece of Shimmer White. And in the stamp set, you have this fun, I don't know, I'm going to call it a peacock. That's what I'm going to go with. But it's like this bird that you see a lot of the time in the fall. So I'm going to stamp him in smoky slate. But I'm going to stamp off first. And then I'm going to stamp him on my shimmer white. Gives me a really, really faint image of our little bird. And then we're going to go in. So we already talked about our wide bristle brush, our medium brush. Now we're going to go to our fine tip brush and we're going to color our bird in. So let's see here. We're going to bring in our Cajun Craze. I'm going to set that here. I have a little bit of cherry cobbler. I have some pumpkin pie. And from earlier, I have our Granny Apple Green on our acrylic black. And those are the colors we're going to use. So I'm going to get some water flowing. Make sure our bristles are wet over in the lid. And dry it off just a titch. And then I'm going to start filling in our bird. So as you can see, you can get some really, really fine detail watercoloring in here. So I'm just putting down a real light color of Cajun Craze. And what that's doing is it's setting some base color. And I'm going to do it here too. And it's also getting our paper wet with the water. Okay. Now I'm going to come back and I'm going to get lots of color and I'm going to do his little feather on top. Look at how fine that is. Okay. And then I'm going to come back and grab some more water and then I can start adding more color as I go. Get some more color there. I want some more color over here. Okay. Good. So on underneath here, I started with a layer of Cajun Craze. I'm going to zoom in just a little bit. I'm going to come over and I'm going to add some cherry cobbler in there. So it's kind of a mix of cherry cobbler and Cajun Craze. I want to continue the cherry cobbler down here. Color that. I'm going to squeeze out some more water. Get my brush a little bit wetter. And I'm just following the images of the stamp. If you go outside the lines, it's no problem. All right, just give that a little clean off and I'm going to come and grab some pumpkin pie over here. I think I want all, I'm going to do all of this in pumpkin pie. I guess I'm going to fill him all in. Okay. No two will come out the same. Okay. I'm going to clean this off. And I'm going to pick up some Granny Apple Green over here. Got my hand in there. I'm sorry. Okay, come out a little bit and grab some Granny Apple Green. And we're going to fill in his little base feathers here. So I can really get some detail with these brushes. They're very, very nice to work with. They hold plenty of water in the barrel, which is exciting. All right, I'm gonna squeeze out some water and clean off that brush with a little. So I always have like a little paper towel or a little wipe or something on the side so that you can clean off your brush and go between colors. Now I've already squeezed in my smoky slate. I'm not gonna add any water, so I'm just gonna get some couple of nice good swipes of color. All I wanna do is dot his little eye. Okay. Again, squeeze some water's coming out and clean that off. And the brush comes nice and clean for you. Okay, so I just wanted a little watercolor bird, like so. And there is a die in the stamp sets and the bundle. I do want to note before I close these up that if you have residual water in your lid, you want to absorb up that water. You do not want that water going onto your ink pad. So I'm going to do that for the Cajun Craze. Get that water. But there's a lot of ink on there, so I can use that for a future. So I'm just absorbing up the water. Get that closed. And I'm going to do the same thing for my cherry cobbler. Get most of that water up. Okay. And get that closed. All right, so we're gonna take the die cut for the bird on the paper, like so. And we're gonna, you can run him through your machine and cut him out. And that's how he's gonna come out. And we're gonna go back to our card and add a couple of dimensionals behind him and put them on our card. I'm using mini ones, so I'm gonna give him 3. And he's gonna go down here as a little accent. And that's our card featuring the Arrange A Wreath and using all 3 of our new water painters. So I hope you liked the card today. Subscribe to Lisa Brown, Stamp with Lisa Brown, my YouTube channel. And I hope you have a great day and catch me next Sunday for my next Savvy Sunday. Thank you.